We'll go left. Oh my gosh, they weren't joking. Find a path through the portals.
All right, now to find the next portal.
Left again. Wait. Oh, it's just...
Oh, damn it. Okay. Back where I started.
Alright. Find a path through the portals to... Oh, so there's many. Oh, so I guess I need to get up really high. This has to be like sickening.
Damn
like
it. Back where I started.
Wait, what? Hold on. Oh. Oh, that's the door I came in. So did I just go through the right one? So the left portal is our best bet. Wait, okay. Yep, left portal, best bet. Candle next to it.
Statues seem oddly oriented, as if to all fit.
Ha ha! Okay.
The right portal, maybe.
What statue? Like these big statues? These big main ones? Thank you for the clue. Well, I was right that the left one's our best bet. But how do I get to that one? Unless, can I drop down safely? Oh, I can. So this is a different room. Oh, it is a different room. Okay. Interesting. She's got a different thing in her hands.
Damn it. Back where I started.
Oh, come on. I did that already. I'd love to go into that other one.
Gotta find the next portal.
Unless I can knock the stone away or something, but I can't. Oh, maybe I can climb. I mean, I normally would think I could climb if I wanted to, but it's a video game, so... Excellent. greenery and sunlight here. She's got like an animal. Maybe. What? I'm that close to the surface. And in the graveyard.
Must be where Moreau had his lab.
Creepy.
Oh man. Something's moving around. Oh!
Guessing this man didn't come here willingly. Intriguing as machinery goes, but how do I start it up?
Mm-hmm. What? Dearly, I have paid for my wrongs, being exiled from the beautiful deserts and steppes of Ophir to this hideous green country, where all the scents and flavors are so intense they make me sick, fills my heart with sorrow and regret. My only comfort seems to be a small colony of scolopendros, or more scientifically speaking, scolopendromorphs, here referred to as giant centipedes, living in the vicinity of my hut. These wonderful creatures, the sight of which reminds me of home, have most likely chosen this area to settle in because of the presence of Shalmers, whose droppings constitute the food of smaller animals, which in turn are consumed by scolopendros. Sometimes I sneak up on them when they are feeding and admire their hooked limbs, mandibles so sturdy they seem made of iron, and chitinous thoraces shining enough to let one gaze upon one's reflection. Why would you have this? More megascope crystals.
Preserved organs. Hope their donors weren't forced to give them up.
He slept right next to the organs. That's gross. Something's over there. Oh. Portal. Porto. Uh-oh. Gross.
Quite the library. Mostly tomes on mutations and genetics.
Before embarking on any consideration of the mutations undergone by witchers, let alone researching them, one should be aware of the specific physiology and biochemistry of these individuals. The transformations they experienced during the trial of the grasses, which are widely considered to be irreversible, caused witchers to become infertile, while significantly increasing their physical strength and sharpening their senses. The process also deprives witchers of emotions and human reflexes. Although information about the trial of the grasses and other transformations to which young adepts of the witcher craft is subjected, it is strictly protected by master witchers and witcher sorcerers. Ludwig Celeste of Bon Aird claims the albumen of gray scoldopentromorphs, the strain of the giant centipede, more commonly known as pale widows, constituted the basis of witcher mutations. However, all research confirming this theory has been lost. Yeah, I bet it has. Wow. Seems like a lot of smaller.
Crystals. Should mount them in the megascope. Missing two crystals.
Wait.
This crystal must go here. All crystals in place. Show me what you got.
Uh,
just need to pick an entry?
I love this armor.
The 18th of Yule, year 1102. Today I begin my great life's endeavor, one greater and more significant than any I have thus far undertaken. For it relates to me personally, to myself and my son. When 15 years passed, a beast of the forest assaulted me. A witcher came to my aid, saved my life. I could not know that for said salvation, I would in the end pay by relinquishing any say as to my own son's fate. Had I the skill to turn back time, I would have done so, and perished rather than surrender to the witchers my only son. But as it was, on the day when Jerome was taken, I swore an oath on my honor that I would recover my son. Today, following years of research and preparation, I have at last devised a device that allows me to study mutations. If the gods in their goodness grant me but a bit of favor, I shall find a way to reverse said mutations and restore Jerome to a normal life.
Huh. Interesting.
So, Professor wasn't out to enhance Witcher mutations, wanted to reverse them. Wonder if he managed, and if there's anything in it for me.
Observation 22. Despite applying a surfeit of toxic substances, significantly more than usual, the subject displayed no symptoms of overdosing. I believe this to be an effect of the mutations. Thus, a minor success. This mutation should allow Jerome better to tolerate toxicity.
What? Can you enhance my toxicity levels? But trying to reverse mutations. Yeah, thanks for that. I can see it.
Observation number 30. The mutations do not set in at once. Curiously, they do not develop over a span of time. Rather, for a mutation to progress towards completion, the appropriate mutagen must be applied continuously. The subject does not bear this well, but I found a way to make the mutations less taxing, invasive. To the mutagen base, I add the albumin of a mutated giant centipede egg. Stored in a glass terrarium, the eggs do not develop, remain small. The eggs themselves are a sight to behold. Mutated, they are luminescent, emitting a wondrous glow. I can only hope my addition of the albumin will produce no significant side effects. Time will tell.
So he's trying to recreate the mutations, and then he's going to find a way to reverse them. Okay. Perhaps.
Observation 58. Sometimes failure is the catalyst for success. I've discovered a method by which one type of mutagen may be transmuted into another through the addition of certain ingredients. This is a great day for science. In addition, I observed that today's dose of mutagens brought the subject to the brink of death. He then suddenly awoke, revived, his strength renewed. Not wholly, of course, but he did in a sense come back from the edge of death. Whether this is attributable to his mutations or to pure coincidence cannot be ascertained. I must conduct further experiments.
Does he have a witcher in there, or what? Or was that Jerome that he experimented on?
Years of experiments, research, sacrifice, all for naught. I have failed to achieve my defined objective. Each mutation I applied to my subjects proved ineffective when applied to Jerome. What I meant to cure him of his witcherism, that which I meant to restore to him a normal life, only deepened his mutations, further augmented his speed and strength, rendered him yet more inhuman. It seems my son must remain a witcher forever. I have failed. The time has come to abandon this place. Return home to Lydia. She may yet deign to take me back. The contraption and mutagens I leave here, let them wither and crumble, as did my dreams of regaining my son.
He's still your son. Yeah.
So the professor wanted to reverse the mutation's effects. Ended up deepening them. Stroke of luck for me. Could profit from his failure.
Let's summarize.
So, Professor tried to neutralize the effects of Witcher mutations. Only managed to enhance them, though. Used the albumens of giant centipede eggs as his mutagen base. Need to go on an egg hunt.
Yeah, maybe down that big giant hole. Am I gonna have to go in there? I don't want to go in there. Alright. Gross. Should have done this a second ago, but still have a fair amount of mutations on, or potions, I guess. Ouchie, hang on. Sorry, eat your eggs. Gross. Oh, I think I was being poisoned for a second. This is cool.
Show me what you got.
Oh, what? Oh, 15 charges left. Okay. Let me hit you! gosh, you're so annoying. Shortcut. Oh, thank you. I almost didn't do it. Place them in the... In here? In where? In here?
Guessing this man didn't come here willingly.
Yeah, okay. Get undressed and activate. We're gonna just gonna hop on in. Just gonna hop on in.
Nobody
okay.
Where it goes. Gear. And how do I start to drop my armor? Leave my weapons.
Oh, okay. It's gonna make me. Okay. Okay. It's fine. We're in our gym gym. We're completely naked in our stupid weird knickers.
Professor's mutagens might work on me as they did on his son. Well, time to find out.
I'm just gonna hop up! I don't think this is what Yennefer meant when she said to be careful. Also, this is probably gonna hurt. Like, I can't imagine that going through it, something that was like the Trial of the Grasses would be easy. Oh, wow. Whoa! I've unlocked the mutation system. It should gain new capabilities, increasing your advantage over normal men, and giving you an added edge in killing monsters. Ooh. Go to the character page? Oh! Press Y to open. Oh my gosh! To use mutations, first you must research them. To do this, choose one of the available mutations. Improve by researching mutations. Strengthen synapses does what? Devote a number of ability points and mutagens to it. Choose one of the advanced. This one? Or... Each time you're injured in melee combat, the attacking opponent receives damage in the amount of 1.5% of damage dealt per report of your toxicity level. Heck yeah. Ooh, I did an achievement. Each point of toxicity increased damage dealt by swords and sign intensity. Can I not do it? Oh. Okay. Press A to activate it. Only one mutation can be active at any given time. Okay. The strength and synapses mutation improves automatically when you develop other mutations. As it does, it unlocks additional ability slots. What? Huh? To see what mutation is currently active, open the mutation panel. The strength and synapses mutation improves automatically when you develop. Okay. Oh my gosh, I've got more. Oh, cool. So it's locked for now. Can I unlock this one? A greater green mutagen, but I can make that. I can make one. I don't remember. What? Oh, I think I didn't want that one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh. Rebus. Ah! Raider Green Mutagen. Oh! Interesting. Okay, I don't have enough to make more of them. I thought I had tons of green. Okay. Oops. Each point toxicity increases damage to. Okay. Each adrenaline point decreases damage received by 15%. Okay, so it's like a combination one. This is really cool. I think I like this mutation better right now. I think it is active. Applying critical effects to opponents activates a random decoction. Wow. Requirements, cat eyes. Oh. Fatal blow, dismembers. Cool. Oh, wow. I think I prefer the alchemy ones, but. Whoa, that's cool. That's. Okay. It can only be triggered once every 180 seconds. Okay, that makes sense. Ooh, you can freeze them. Opponents knocked down and frozen, simultaneously die immediately. Oh my gosh, that's really good. Oh. Wow. Huh. We'll need a greater blue mutagen for that. Well, I could just, Oh, and there's, Oh, right. Oh, okay, so this is what. Okay. Okay, I see. Okay. So it's me leveling up, but not, like, I had these points that I didn't know what to do with, but, okay, I see. Okay. Okay. What do I want to put in there? I think I've gotten those. I don't even use the secondary ability. On those, really. Right. Didn't use that. I mean, I guess you might as well. Interesting. Okay, so it gives you something to do with the extra points. I like that. I like that a lot. That's very cool. Yeah, I need to put my clothes and whatnot back on. Manticore. I need the steel sword. Oh no, wait, was I using the old fairy one? Yes. Manticore armor. Manticore boots. Manticore pants. And wolf gauntlets. I did look at what this did. It'd be cool to display it, but I really should probably sell it. I need the money. A relic. Killing opponent restores. Ooh, so if you have like 6 relics. Oh, I think if I had the full set of sword of the Teshnamutna armor. That's cool. So it's like vampiric, right? It's like a life force sucking thing. That's cool. Alright. Leave the laboratory. Wasn't there somebody else, though? That was
a power cell for portals. Feels dead.
Oh, that's right.
Maybe a sign will revive it.
I feel like we have a problem, though. I thought. Oh, no. Up. Oh, we did. We don't have a problem. We're fine. It's nighttime. I spent a long time in there. Swim swiftly. Probably have to hit up some treasure, like monster stashes, so that way I can get the money. Fireflies! Alright, well, I'm not sure how I'm gonna be, if I'm gonna separate this one or have it be one long one, but that was cool! I really like that system, because I was like, I have all these points, not all, but I have a bunch of points that I just don't, I like my current setup that I've got, I don't want to change it. But this will let me be a little bit more alchemical if I want. I guess I could just take away almost all the signs and everything and just like, or like, have it be like, just try to unlock all the alchemy stuff. But I don't use all, I have most of the alchemy stuff unlocked that I want. Other stuff's like grenades and stuff, and I don't really use the grenades. I just mostly focus on like potions and oils and stuff. But yeah, wow, that was cool. Thank you guys for joining me. Sorry I clapped, that's probably kind of loud. But maybe next time we will find the bootblack who appeared in the vision. We'll see. But yeah, thank you guys again, and I will see you in the next one.